Became a full-time organizer on November 9th. Gave up my retirement, come back to Rockland County, and with a group of incredible people, started something called the Rockland Citizens Action Network, and that's where I ran into this woman, because we did not have a candidate in the Democratic Party who would stand up to Ed Day, the big, powerful Ed Day. When Attorney General Snyderman handed out a directive to all schools, to all police, to all areas of government, saying the laws of New York concerning immigration are these. Don't let people come into your schools. Don't let people come and take people from their homes. There needs to be a reaction against what is happening in Washington. Tip O'Neill said, all politics is local, and I really believe that. We can think and get angry and yell at the TV, God knows I've done that. But until you get really great people with the background that she has, take from her life the opportunity to represent us, I said I have to, and being from Stony Point, at that moment, said I am going to do everything I can to ignite Democrats in Stony Point to get this woman back and elect her to become county executive. So you're the reason why I'm here today, and I do appreciate it. And the intelligence is just amazing. So
he's one of my brain trusts, by the way. That's why I'm saying that.
So we are all gathered here in a, I hope, a heartfelt effort to become Democrats. It's a proud heritage. I took a ride down Grassy Point this morning to try to find where our James Farley kind of had a put something in cement, Ed Finn told me, to try to find it. I looked, I couldn't find it. But it was good being down in Grassy Point, knowing that a man who helped shape the New Deal, and who was, as I read his history, was one of the most egalitarian human beings on the face of the earth. He was in FDR's kitchen cabinet, and I think, I know, after the defeat of Hillary Clinton, I wanted to go to a demonstration in New York City, and my historian friend from Vermont says, no, we're going to Franklin Delano Roosevelt's home. That's really where I did recapture my sense of balance. We don't need anything else at this moment than to begin to realize what Franklin Delano Roosevelt did. He established a system of social trust in this country, which is now being deliberately broken down on every level of institution in the United States. And sometimes the greatest way that we can protect the rights of the national government is that we have to make sure those rights on the local government will never be transgressed. So we're in this together. A lot of people think I'm liberal or too liberal. I read FDR today. I can. If you're gonna call me anything, call me an FDR Democrat. I can live with that, and I can speak my social conscience and everything I need to, because if we just can get back to that space in our political dialogue, we'll be headed in the right direction.